say, well,
awesome. Thank you all for being here. Real quick before I get started, LD16 just censured two of their legislators for voting for this debacle. And I recently met one of the candidates. He's here, Thomas Greer. Raise your hand, Thomas. I don't, right behind me. Recently met him. I don't know him well, but I do know this. He won't vote for abortion. He won't vote for a massive tax increase. And he won't vote to expand Obamacare in Arizona. And for that, I'm grateful. Well, here we are. I'm Representative Warren Peterson. And thanks to just a handful of misguided Republicans, the expansion of Obamacare has passed the legislature. And we are now down to our last line of defense, which is you, the people. And it's going to take every single citizen, precinct committeeman, and activist who loves freedom to rise up and to repeal this monstrosity. So this is a great turnout. This is a great turnout. I thank all of you for being here. We have enough people, I know, to make this happen. Because I had a few out of the people that responded to me, maybe two were able to come. I probably had 100 that said, Warren, I'm going to help you collect petitions. So I'm going to be real brief. I'm going to cover a couple things. We have a lot of people here that want to speak. First of all, I just want to talk about, it doesn't take a critical thinker to recognize that the media has supported this. The other side has had millions of dollars. They have the media. They have a lot of support. We don't have all those things, but we do have facts, and we do have the right ideas. One thing, this idea of free health care, this is not a new idea. This is old, okay? In fact, there was a country that's government collapsed 20 years ago, and right in their constitution, Article 42 of their constitution, the citizens were promised free health care. And that government collapsed 20 years ago. That doesn't work. What we got to get back to is our country, which was the new idea, which created the most prosperous and free and compassionate and powerful society, which was this. You are guaranteed, if the government takes something from you, you're guaranteed just compensation. Your property rights will be protected. It's a society that believes in freedom and capitalism. That's what we got to get back to. Now, some of the corruption that I've seen and the tactics that I've seen have been really disappointing. On the one hand, literally, you've had legislators that have been offered massive fundraisers. They've been offered political cover to pass these things. There was a rally that was not held not too long ago where 300 people were bussed in to feign support. You know, there have been people down here at the Capitol for 40 years that have never seen the shenanigans that went on, suspending rules, threatening to remove our president and our speaker, and doing all these things, all for the sake of Obamacare. And let me just finish by saying this. Compulsion is not compassion. We all know that. We can't sit down here as a legislature and pat ourselves on the back for giving other people's money away, okay? That's not compassion. Reaching into our own pockets and giving other people money, that's compassion. I've read the Bible from the front cover to the back cover, and nowhere will you find in there that it tells you it's compassionate to give somebody else's money away. Now, we have a great group of people here. It doesn't take a lot of people, but with your effort, we can defeat this. Thank you all for being here.
I'd like to recognize the other members of the legislature that are here today. Of course, Representative Warren Peterson is here. State Representative Adam Quasman. State Representative John Kavanaugh. State Representative John Allen. State Representative Carl Seal. State Representative Kelly Townsend, State Representative Eddie Farnsworth, State Senator Al Melvin, State Senator Judy Burgess, State Representative Steve Smith. I keep trying to want to say State Senator when I read that. It'll be next year. He'll be back. State Representative David Gowan. And did I miss any sitting members? And we have a few former members here. We have State Representative Terry Proud is here. There's Terry over there. And former State Senator Russell Pierce is here. And I want to recognize one other guy. He's out in the audience somewhere. His name is Mike Jeans. He's the clerk of the court. He's going to get to see a lot of us when the governor sues us on this, because she's going to sue us. But Mike is out there as well. Well, I'm former State Senator Frank Antonori. Thank you guys for coming out. Myself, I get to Ron. He gets to talk. Ron's going to talk in a minute. Thanks, everybody, for coming out here today and taking time. We have a monumental task in front of us. If you read all the reports in the media, they say we can't get it done. The left has this thing, they go, si se puede, yes we can. But when we say we're going to go out and do something, everybody goes, no they can't, no they can't. Well, I'm telling you what, I spent 20 years fighting for this country. I've been in Afghanistan, Iraq, Saudi Arabia, Somalia, all the armpits of this planet. And they, trust me, they are the armpits of the planet. There is no greater country on earth than this country right here. And the reason this country is great, is not because of the people that reside on the ninth floor or it's 1400 or 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. The reason this country is great is because if you look around to your left and right, it's the people that make this country great. So now is our chance. Now is our chance. We have to come together and we have to fight to get this on the ballot. We have a lot of work to do between now and September 10th when we have to get all these signatures and these petitions submitted. So everybody's got to go out there and do their little part. We've got guys all over the world fighting for freedom. They've laid their life on the line. Many of them didn't come home. Think of the sacrifice that they made. All we're asking you to do is take a few hours of your day, maybe a weekend or an evening, to go out to parking lots, shopping centers, to go to homeowners association meetings, any event you can see on any community calendar in which you reside, bring some petitions with you and sign as many people up on that petition as you can. Any registered voter in the state of Arizona can sign the petition. We need you to work hard and get out there and get this done. We can do it, not we. Si se puede. I'm saying we can do it. This is America. The people of the state have a right to refer any legislation to the ballot, and we're going to do it. We're going to get it done, and we're going to show the naysayers, and we're going to show those that support big government that we will stand in their way every step of the way, and will not let that happen. So I'd like to turn it over now to my co-chairman, Senator Ron Gould, who spends a lot of time on hot roofs, so he's dressed for the occasion.
The equation, huh?
The occasion.
The occasion. Good morning. I am overwhelmed to see how many people are here today. This is going to be an overwhelming effort to get this on the ballot. The statewide, or let me rephrase that, the formerly statewide daily newspaper of Arizona says we can't do that. I think we can.
Yes.
And let me bring up something else. I'm getting a little tired of the governor and her Saul Alinsky-like tactics. You saw a quote from Matthew Benson, who's paid for with your tax dollars, because apparently the governor can't speak for herself. She has to hire a spokesman to come down and speak for us. They said, is this best for the state of Arizona, or is this best for two out-of-work former legislators? Interesting comment, because I've worked my business the entire time I was in the legislature. Frank worked at Raytheon the entire time he was at the legislature. We aren't out of work, folks. We're doing this because we love our state. We love our country. And I don't want to see our nation go down the tubes into socialism, because I have two grandchildren that are less than 2 years old. They deserve to grow up in the nation that you and I grew up in. Yeah. They don't deserve to grow up in a European-style socialist nation with low productivity, low output, and a poor standard of living. They were born here, folks. They deserve to live the American dream just like you and I. This is going to be a big deal. We need each one of you to recruit about 50 more people to get this done. We can do this. We can do this. It's going to be hot. It's not the greatest time of the year. I'm from Lake Havasu, so this is reasonable weather here today. But this is not the greatest time to be doing this. But what the upside is, people will be hunkered down in their houses in the afternoons when you come and knock on their door to get their signature. They won't be off running around. They'll be at home. They're waiting for you to show up to knock on their door to get their signatures or to register them to vote. We can do this. It can be done. Let's show the moderates, quote moderates, in our party that we're not going to tolerate this. We are the Republican Party. We have a set of principles. If you don't like our principles, there's another party that has a different set of principles. Sign up for that party. Sign up for that party. Once again, I just ask that God would bless you for showing up here today. God bless the legislators that are standing behind me and behind you in your effort. They'll be organizing also to help us attain this goal. We need to do this, folks. This will become the first nationwide referendum against Obamacare. Nowhere else in America has this been done. It's going to be done. It starts today. Let's get it done. Put on your walking shoes. Put on your sunscreen. Put on your hat. Let's get it done, folks. God bless you. God bless Arizona. God bless America.
Hi, I'm Christine Balzerman, and I'm helping these guys with this mission, okay? We have to stop this takeover of our state. I would like to know when a hospital, a corporate entity, got a seat at the table to pass our state budget, and they removed our state speaker and our president to do it, who we elected to be there. The chamber, we have a chamber of commerce who's supposed to represent our business interests in this state. And you know what they're doing? They're forming a committee to fight our committee, our people's veto. And Republicans, I am a Republican, and we are Republicans. I don't think they were moderate Republicans who voted those 15. I don't claim them to be Republicans at all. And I'm tired of hearing that there's something wrong with the Republicans. There's nothing wrong with the Republican Party. We are the party of limited government and fiscal sanity. And we know how to read the Constitution. And guess what it says? It says we could do a people's veto. So here's your referendum, okay? These two sheets go together and they can never become unattached. This is a set. You have a petition and a bill, all right? We are seeing a lot of Obama tactics, and we don't want to go into Florida where we have the governor lining up our holes to make sure there's no error, that they weren't unattached and reattached. If they are unattached, they will not count. At the front is a little line right here. You have to do this by county. So if you're in two different counties, you have to have one for each county. Ask the people, are you registered to vote in Arizona? Republican, Democrat, Independent, PND, they can all sign this. And there is no reason to play any games and lie. We have the issue. It's no Obamacare, no Medicaid expansion in this state. Okay? And when you're done, if you don't fill it all out, you can blank it out. You don't have to fill it all out, but it would be nice if you do. Turn it over. And on the back, you have to have it notarized by somebody. The banks will notarize them. We have notaries set up all over the place, okay? And then you can mail it to the mail address that's online, or you can turn it into the different people who are set up to do them, okay? We have gotten rid of almost 5,000 ballots here today. Petitions, thank you. Petitions and bill, because they're a set. We have gotten rid of 1,000 already. We want these back by July the 8th, and then you can get some more. And I know it's a lot of work, and I know we're gonna work hard, but we're gonna do it, right? And then we'll do a second wave that'll be done the end of August. All right, so now we're gonna do a group signing. Everybody get your petition, get your pen. Come here, Frank.
What was that? Oh, we're gonna do the official signing. So the governor had her signing ceremony. We're gonna have ours right now. Let me have that. So, if everybody's got one, if you got one handy, break out your pen.
22nd.
All right, there it is. We're good. We're off and running. Let's go get those 100,000 signatures and send this thing to the voters in November 2014. Thank you, guys. Thank you for coming. I want to also, AJ, I forgot. AJ LaFaro is going to be instrumentally involved in collecting and helping us up here in Maricopa County. Go to your LD chairman and then go to AJ if you need any help, or you can go to our website, urapc.org. All of those places, we will help you any way we can. If you need a notary, if you need more petitions, if you need legal help, if someone's giving you a hard time, let us know. We are here to help you. So let's go get this done. Let's knock it out. And ladies and gentlemen, let's fight this fight. We can win this. Thank you for coming today. Oh, hold on 1 second. Where's Christine? Where did she go? I didn't know the addresses. So we're going to do, after this, we're going to go walk some neighborhoods. For those of you that want to make a little statement, we're going to go out to the two legislative districts of the two ringleaders of this effort, which were John McComish in the Senate and Heather Carter in the House. So we're going to go out to the Chandler area and start getting signatures, and then in the Deer Valley area. So we're going to be meeting where? At the Deer Valley Airport for the Heather Carter effort?
Yeah.
All right, so the Deer Valley Airport. It's going to be near the restaurant on Deer Valley Road, 702 West Deer Valley Road. And where are we doing the McComish one at?
The LD18 will be at the McDonald's at 48th and Warner. 48th and Warner, right there in the 48th and Warner at 1 o'clock in the northwest quadrant there. For those individuals from LD18, you know where that is. For those that don't, please show up. We're going to be... No, I'm not going out in the suit to go collect signatures. I'm going to change. Okay? Yep. Huh?
We're good.
LD15's Deer Valley.
We're good.
Deer Valley Airport.
All right. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you.